Now today in this session of business studies, we will be discussing about the various characteristics of management. Management, we already know that it is an art of getting the work done through others. Okay. Now, what are the various features which are being possessed in management? Management में ऐसी कौन सी विशेषता है? So we have noted down few characters for you. We will explain this thing in brief for you. Management, it is said that it is a goal-oriented activity. The whole focus of the management is on the achievement of the goal. So manager, he tries to achieve the goals of the organization by making the use of the various resources in a judicious manner. So the complete emphasis is lying on the orientation of goal only. So goal-oriented activity. It is universal requirement. Management is required everywhere. When we are talking about the management, not only in the business but also in the non-business organization, if any activity is to be done, we require the management there, because management is related with group. Where the number of persons are working in a group, we have to manage the various activities which are being done in the different group. So it is said that management is required everywhere, not only in business but also in non-business organization. Then come, it is a group effort, because the activities are divided, and those activities which are being divided are being done or performed by a number of persons. So when number of persons who are working in a particular group for achieving the same target or the task or the goals of the organization, so there is the need of the management to coordinate the efforts of all the group. सभी ग्रुप के efforts को coordinate करने के लिए management की जरूरत होती है. And management, it helps only in those activities, it is most suitable in those activities where the group or the number of persons are working together. It is an intangible activity. Management is an intangible activity. Because we cannot see, we cannot touch it. We can only feel the presence of the management, that when we have achieved a certain task or a target or the goal which we want to achieve, and if we have achieved that goal successfully, अगर हम कोई काम करना चाहते थे और वो काम हमने successfully कर लिया है, so that means there was a presence of management. The success of any organization or any task which shows that there was a management in that work. Okay, so it is an intangible activity. So success is only the parameter through which you can measure this thing, that you have managed all the activities properly. Then comes, it is an organized activity. Management is an organized activity because work is divided into number of activities, and then those activities are being performed by different persons who have been appointed for doing that work. That's why it is said that it is an organized activity. When we want to achieve certain tasks, first we have to see that how we can achieve that task, what are the various activities which we have to perform for achieving that task, and then for performing each and every task separately, who will be appointed, how many persons will be required by us so that they can do their work. So all these are being done in an organized manner. That's why we said that management is an organized activity. It is said that management is a continuous process. It is a never-ending process, because once we are done with one particular task or completed with one particular goal, we will move to another. So management keeps on continuing. So it is said that management starts when we start the business and it ends with the business. जब ये शुरू होता है, तो जब हमने कोई टास्क या बिजनेस शुरू किया, तो ये मैनेजमेंट शुरू होता है और ये खत्म भी बिजनेस और उस टास्क के साथ होता है जो हम करना चाहते थे. इफ वी हैव अचीव दैट थिंग, देन इट विल एंड. बट इफ इट इज अ कंटीन्यूअस वर्कआउट, सो अगेन द न्यू टास्क विल कम. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज सेड दैट इट इज अ कंटीन्यूअस प्रोसेस. देन मैनेजमेंट इज अ डायनामिक फंक्शन. मैनेजमेंट इज ट्रीटेड एज अ डायनामिक फंक्शन. There are different functions of management, like planning, organizing, staffing. directly can control it. But why it is said a dynamic function? Because we have to keep on changing the various activities of the management, various functions of management, as and when required from time to time, according to the need and the requirement of the organization. जैसे जैसे समय के साथ हमारी जरूरतें बदलती जाएगी, हमारी नीड्स बदलती जाएगी, तो हमारे मैनेजमेंट करने के तरीकों में भी बदलाव आता रहेगा. So that's why it is said that it is a dynamic function, because it keeps on changing with the changes in the needs and the requirement. Okay? Then it is a multi-dimensional activity. Management is a multi-dimensional activity. It is a multi-dimensional task, because management of work, management of people and management of resource, ये तीन चीजें होती हैं. We have to manage the various types of activities in the organization. We have to manage the manpower in the organization, that the activities which we are performing are to be performed by different persons, so we have to manage them also. And then the management of operation. Okay, the management of operation. Whatever work we are doing, we have to do that work in a proper manner. So that's why it is said that management is a multi-dimensional activity. It is having a three dimension: management of work, management of people, and management of operational activities. So these were some of the features of management. ये management के कुछ features थे which we have discussed in this session. Okay, hope you understand the various features of management and you will be able to clearly make the use of various features of management as and when required by you. Thank you and have a nice day.